Hello, everybody. My name is Daniel Wang. I'm one of the many DJs who lives here in Berlin, one of the thousands in our capital of electronic music. And I'm here today to show you some of my favorite B-sides. Okay, well, I should give you a little warning. I'm not exactly a techno guy, and I just turned 50 about a month ago, and I decided to not be shy anymore about showing what I know, because a lot of this music is based on a deep amount of knowledge about that's been built up over a very long time. My first record is Cool and the Gang, Morning Star, which is the B-side of the very famous disco single Celebration on the D-Light label, which also released Crown Heights Affair, another wonderful 70s disco jazz band. And we have this from 1980, 33 RPM, 118 beats per minute. Let's talk a little bit about it, though, because it's the B-side, and why B-sides are interesting traditionally is B-sides allow the artists to do something, to release a track they worked on, which probably would not be a commercial hit. And especially in the 70s and 80s, the commercial hit was a vocal song that had an uplifting message or a catchy hook. And if you released instrumental tracks back then, or even nowadays, with serious chord changes, with unusual effects, the larger mainstream audience might not get into it. So I think the B-sides back then, the producer was realistic, they would make something good and they would throw it on the B-side as an extra treat, so to say, for the listener. And with this, we have a production by Eumir, Eumir Deodato. Deodato is also known for a few disco hits like A Whistle Bump, Keep On Moving, and of course he's from Brazil, and in the mid-70s he got famous producing on the CTI label by Creed Taylor with, for example, Afternoon of a Faun, by Debussy, and also Azul Sprach Zarathustra, another class, I think it's Wagner, isn't it? So in around 1976 to 1978, I think he got more technically aware in the studio, and in 1980 he's producing this stuff and Cool and the Gang and more commercial disco hits. Notice underneath is a Lin drum sound. I think it is. And we're going to listen very briefly. It's in the key of, okay, it's in the key of E. And we have an EAD here, change here. Yeah. You hear that? So you hear that? What we had was a basic 2-5-1 change. If we start in the key of E, which is the 2, it goes up to the A, which is the 5. I'm sorry, it's actually a 1-5-2. And it goes back down to the, oh, it is a 2-5-1. And then down to the D, which is the 1. The D is the 1, the E is the 2, the A is the 5. So we're moving always between these three keys, and that's a very basic, you might say, jazz or pop music maneuver. And then in the middle, what makes this record so magical is it opens up into a major key, probably going up a fifth, probably going up into the A or something else, and then these horn solos come in. So for me, this has a very magical sound. It's very danceable, it's 118 BPM, and it's definitely something for jazz funk lovers like yourself. The second record here, you're wondering why I'm holding a DVD, is Illusion Orchestra, Autumn Leaves. And on the B-side, this has a gem. Why am I showing you Autumn Leaves? because the original A side was this song, which is an old jazz standard. Autumn leaves, da 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 da, da 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 window, da 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 da, da 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 da. This old song was composed by Vladimir Kozma, who coincidentally also wrote the music for the soundtrack of this 1980s French new wave hit, Diva. Interesting connection, because I think Autumn Leaves was already written in the 50s or 60s or even earlier, and this film he did in the early 80s. So, moving on the B side of Illusion Orchestra, which was produced by Julie Swain, who also did Innocence, Let's Push It, in early 1990, I believe, we have a secret hit called Backtracking. How good is this track? It's very good. Let's listen to it. ...45 RPM. Okay, what is there to say about this record? It's very simple. First of all, it's about 124 BPM, and it's definitely a mechanical drum machine. I would say very obviously a famous Linn drum machine, L-I-N-N. And all of you DJ producers out there know it, but for those who don't, it's probably most famous for, among other records, Madonna's first album on Burning Up and Lucky Star, another hits of hers from about 1983. The Linn drum was one of the first drum machines that used samples, so it's not like an 808 or 909, which made sound from analog waves, circuits. It was recordings, tiny digital microchip recordings, and you could switch the chips out, which would make these sounds which sounded relatively realistic, but were also very tight and punchy at the same time. The song is happening in the key of F sharp. Yeah. It's a rough match, and there's an interesting story about this B-side because, oh, by the way, Jolie Swain, the producer team, also produced this famous album, Imagination, Body Talk, and a lot of the hits by Imagination. But the really interesting thing is, if you listen to Wham, Everything She Wants, you'll notice it's actually the same groove and the same key, only slowed down to about 118 BPM. And this record from Julie Swain, Illusion Orchestra, called Backtracking, comes out in 1982. This record by Wham, also from the UK, comes out in 1985. And personally, I should say, I love what George Michael did. I love so many of his songs. I think it's very sad he died. But I would guess probably he may have been inspired, not only a little bit indirectly, by this interesting B-side that we just played. If you don't believe me, play them next to each other and check it out. And now we're on to record number three, a very famous, how do you say it? I keep saying that word famous, you know, that's what the Japanese say. Yume na rekodo. It's a famous record from the, I think this is from 1980. It was produced by Dexter Wenzel, who did a lot of really important records, his own records. He also produced The Stylistics around 1980. He produced The Jones Girls. He did a lot of great things on Philly International. This record, although it's under the name MFSB, was actually mostly his production, a studio work, and not the large orchestra, which was also more or less the same members as the Salsa Orchestra from Philadelphia. And this, to me, is the real gem. Here we go. Just let it play. Beautiful music needs no words to explain it. Thank you. I'll let you discover that record on your own, but there are two interesting things to say about this. BPM, I'm not exactly sure. Obviously, it's a human drummer, not a drum machine. I think maybe it's 105, 110, something what we call mid-tempo. And it's not a straight 4-4 beat going doom, 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 like house music or like techno. It's got a bit of groove and funk and jazz. But it's also a surprisingly simple progression. It's actually in C minor. And it goes through the most basic 1-5-4 changes. C to the G to the F. Here we go. Hear that? And there's one more interesting thing to say about this, which is, surprisingly, this is the instrumental version of another vocal song by an entirely different group, but actually also produced by Dexter Wansell. Here we have Jones Girls, At Peace With Woman, the title track, which was never really a hit. And I think the producers realized that the vocal was just too good to, I mean the instrumental track, was too good to leave alone. So here we are. Here it is again. Surprise. At Peace With Woman by the Jones Girls, produced by Dexter Wansell. And here we are with record number 4, a fairly famous disco hit called Strut Your Funky Stuff by Frantique. It actually was a Philadelphia US release too, but this is a licensed European pressing. The B-side then is Getting Serious, which is a track which seems to have never been played out, but I quite adore it. Here we go. We're not going to play the A-side, it's too well known. I'm sure you can all find it on YouTube. A few things to say. First of all, again, we can look at the keys. It's a very basic pop blues key change. It's actually, again, C minor to G to F, a so-called 1-4-5. If you look on your piano keyboard, the C is the 1, the F is the 4, and the G is the 5. You can count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that's what we're talking about. You can use these numbers in combinations that make a kind of loop that go back and forth, and that makes for the basics of basis of a lot of music, including Johann Sebastian Bach. We have and there's a lovely phaser break at the end, which gives a lot of tension. It's very dark, after all. Okay, and that's the outro. And you can see, actually, it's very simple. The chords are being played on some kind of solina or string machine from the late 70s, early 80s, but they're using a phaser effect, which gives it that sloshy feeling. And as much as so many people say music is this religious and spiritual experience and blah, 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 and you see thousands of people now at raves and festivals partying their heads off, taking drugs, underneath are some very simple mechanisms. One could even say that music is a manipulation of your emotions. It's the mathematics of the soul. But when you use your technical gadgets correctly and the right chords, you can make interesting psychological effects on the masses. Finally, for my fifth record, I'm playing something which all of you DJs who've been collecting records for many years know is one of the best B-sides ever. But knowing that in our audience we have many younger members who are just starting or have only heard the more electronic side of music so far, we're playing the B-side of Chic, I Want Your Love, a very famous hit, which was which has also been re-edited and sampled so many times. The B-side is a slightly obscure track in E major, has a very bright, happy sound, as you know, music theorists would say, in 101 BPM. Here we are, Chic, Funny Bone. Okay, what do we have here? Notice, key of E major. Hear that? Just a few things to say. First of all, if you really listen to the record closely, it's interesting. It's got two parts. The first part, which is kind of the vamp, you would say, or the kind of basic riff, is just the E key. And the bass line keeps going da-da-da-da-da. Let's see. Right? From the D, just a D flat, to the D to the E. So it's just a three notes going da-da-da-da-da-da, making a very simple pattern, and then the second part, the bass just stays in E, and you've got these violin vamps. So you've actually got sort of like chocolate and strawberry together. And you go from chocolate to strawberry, back to chocolate, back to strawberry, and you get an interesting mix of ice cream flavors, or layers, I guess you should say. It's always important to think of the drumming. When you've got a techno drummer or a machine doing the drumming, it doesn't have that human touch. And here, drumming is a lot like punctuation when you're writing a sentence or a paragraph. And that's what I'm thinking, at least, and that's what maybe the drummer is doing. You're segmenting time. And segmenting time is done with the kick drum, the snare drum, the congas. And at the end of every sentence or phrase, you've got a cha, a crash cymbal. So this combination of magical human organic elements with the great band Chic and Bernard Edwards on bass makes this a wonderful B-side that you can play on any dance floor to rock the party. I hope you enjoyed that little segment with me. Sorry for talking so much, but here in the age of internet and social media, it's nice to use this medium to spread a bit of passion and knowledge, because I realized I'm someone who cares a lot about this. I hope everyone has a good time at the parties, and don't become mechanical robots and take pills and turn your body into a machine. We're human beings because we've got senses and minds and souls, and when done correctly, music is a medium which helps us to dig deeper into ourselves and build bridges with other human beings. So here we've got the three, quite a bit of green here, a bit of black, a bit of blue. And these were my five records for Electronic Beats, and I hope you enjoyed this presentation. My name is Daniel Wang.